Nintendo has a bunch of mascots, and the cutest one is a pink little ball named Kirby. But don't get distracted by his appearance, Kirby is a solid fighter. His main ability consists of swallowing his enemies and taking their powers. And this is exactly what we are interested in today. And since a new Kirby game is gonna launch this week, it's time to find the best shapes Kirby can turn into. I'm NicoBBQ and this is my top 10 Kirby transformations. There's a bunch of cool power-ups Kirby can get. One that is particularly useful is the beam power-up. It allows Kirby to wield some sort of laser beam whip. It can be used to destroy enemies in several directions, not only in front of you, which is really cool. You can also use it to destroy blocks to reveal hidden passages. Plus, in later iterations of the game, Kirby wears this freaking amazing hat. I mean, what's not to love? Kirby can transform into several earth elements, such as water, fire, grass, and wind. The last one is the most interesting of the bunch, cause Kirby can turn into a tornado. While using this power-up, it is not easy to control where you're going to end up, but isn't that how tornadoes work anyways? This power-up can also be used to reach higher grounds in a stylish way. Speaking of stylish, Kirby has a tornado on top of his head. I mean, how cool is that? I like ninjas. I really do, but they scare me shitless at the same time. I mean, imagine someone like Ryu Hayabusa from the Ninja Gaiden series storm your living room. Yeah, that's kinda scary. But this ninja here is not really scary, because yeah, Kirby can transform into a ninja. Is there anything Kirby can't do, really? Having the ninja transformation gives Kirby the ability to throw ninja knives and ninja stars, and just like his NES counterpart from the Ninja Gaiden series, Kirby can hang on walls and do dive jumps. I have a weird reason for liking this next power-up. I like the Kirby cutter, but not because of the cutter itself, but because of the hat. Really, the hat sold it for me. But what is also cool about this ability is that Kirby can use the cutter like a sword if he goes close range, but he can also throw them like boomerangs to create a long-ranged weapon. Also in Kirby 64, when Kirby uses the cutter ability, he actually throws a little bit of his own body in the process. That is gross, but also amazing at the same time. As opposed to most gaming heroes, Kirby can fly right out of the box. No wing cap required. He just inhales air and bada beam bada boom he flies. Despite not needing anything, having a wing cap just makes everything better. I mean, look at Kirby now, he flies like an angel. I'm pretty sure Pit from Kid Icarus is freaking jealous right now. Look at those tricks, I mean, wow. But that isn't all. Having tons of feathers on your head has an advantage. You can use them to attack your enemies. Oh yeah! Do you guys believe in aliens? You know, those green thingies coming from creepy UFOs. I sure wouldn't mind an alien invasion if they all came in pink UFOs like the Kirby UFO transformation. It cannot be used in a lot of levels, but when you turn into a UFO, you can fly wherever you want without any limits. You can also shoot lasers, and everyone knows that shooting lasers is pretty freaking amazing. It's too bad you cannot keep it out of the level, or else it would be higher on this list. Kirby 64 introduced a fun new element, mixing up power-ups. So, what happens if you mix cutter and thunder? Well, you get a freaking double-bladed lightsaber. So now you can mix your love for Star Wars and your love for the cute pink ball that is Kirby. And as I always say, everything is better with a lightsaber. Okay, I don't really say that, I just didn't have anything else to add. Let's go to number 3 right now. What? When I was a kid, my mom always told me not to play with fire, as it was dangerous. Well, it sure doesn't look that dangerous when it's your favorite pink ball that is on fire. The fireball ability turns Kirby into a flaming fireball, ready to burn everything in its path. And it gets even better in Kirby 64, where mixing two flame power-ups turns you into a flaming phoenix. Yes, the mythical bird. That's pretty cool.
NicoBBQ does not condone playing with fire. Please don't do it, kids. Come on.
Kirby can swallow many kind of creatures and get really weird power-ups sometimes. But what if he ate your favorite Nintendo character? Like, what if he ate Mario or Donkey Kong? That would be funny. Too bad we'll never know what power-up Kirby would gain. Oh wait, we can know. Super Smash Bros., one of my favorite games of all time, allows Kirby to swallow almost every Nintendo character in existence. Now you can shoot fireballs like Mario, swallow enemies like Yoshi, shoot electricity like Pikachu, the sky is the limit. And now I cannot wait to see what Kirby will look like after he swallows the Wii Fit Trainer. I mean, what is he gonna turn into? An exercise ball? One of my favorite game series is The Legend of Zelda, and you know that. So, combining both The Legend of Zelda and Kirby can only be amazing, and this is exactly what they did. Having the sword ability was okay in Kirby Adventures for the NES, but then they decided to give Kirby a hat to go with that sword. And which hat did they choose? Oh yeah, Link's hat, baby. The sword ability allows Kirby to cut through any enemies without any remorse. In Kirby Return to Dreamland for the Wii, you can even get the Super Sword, which gives Kirby the biggest sword in the entire world. It is such an amazing power-up that it has been revealed that it's gonna be Kirby's new Final Smash in the upcoming Smash for Wii U and Smash for 3DS. Now, that is what I call a real number one power-up. Alright, so now you saw my best transformations, but what about the worst ones? Well, you're lucky, you can find out right now by clicking here. That's right, two videos this week. Oh yeah! But if you already saw both the videos, well, you might be interested to learn that one of the Kirby games actually predicts a potential planet Earth after a nuclear war. Does that interest you? Oh, yeah? Okay, then click here. Alright? Okay. Alright, see you next time, babies!